to see the richness of hope land upon someone's spirit via rhythm, rhyme, and melody. Sound. I don't understand it.
But a lot of hymns are close your eyes singing to God. I wanted to sing with my eyes wide open, singing to each other.
This thing, Jesus music, found its way in my hometown, and it changed my life.
When it comes to music and how we can express ourselves, we don't have to do it the way it was done before.
You want to find a loving way to have these conversations.
My generation had seen all of the civil unrest. Most of us were trying to escape the pain and the misery.
Where do we go from here?
You feel like something's in the wind.
This soundtrack emerges.
They had no idea they were helping to create an entire industry.
I saw contemporary Christian music born right before my very eyes.
You don't know you're a pioneer or something when you're doing it.
We were just doing what we love.
You had grunge, and you had pop, and you had rock, and you had hip-hop.
There was so much great music going on. Everything felt so fresh and new.
What we were doing said so much across the world.
It was so much drama in the church.
Every setback, there would be a glimmer of hope.
Money, cultural influence, off the charts.
It's bigger than any one person or one artist.
Offers people a sense of hope.
Yeah, there was tension on DC Talks.
Here's the deal.
I've never shared this with anybody.
Would you change anything?
Let's not forget, music is God's idea.
I think music is the most powerful universal language in the world.
Music was a lifeline.
It became part of the fabric of who I was.
It pushed me to do some courageous things. It touches the soul like somebody talking to you can't.
And you can do all that in 3.5 minutes.